library time. So this is actually the last library time of our summer session. So if you were doing Beanstack, please keep making sure you have a couple more days to finish. So finish up, you want to get your numbers in for your school trophy in there, and we still have our prize ballot, so keep that up. And we've got some exciting news to come for fall programs, so stay tuned on our website and our social media, and we'll let you guys know all about our new fall programs in just a few days' time. So now I'm going to go through our new books with you. So since you can't be in the branch with us, I'm just going to show you all the cool new stuff that we're getting in the library that you could check out through our curbside pickup. So we have Goodnight Sleepyville. This is a really sweet book by Blake Hellman, and it's got some beautiful illustrations that just get you in that perfect mood for bedtime and curling up in your bed, and oh, it's just a beautiful book. And then we have in one of our easy readers, PJ Masks are on a new adventure, so flying to the factory, and this is a really fun one, especially if you're a fan of the TV show. This one is very cute, so this is called Sloth Went. Sometimes a little poop can be a big adventure. So this is all about Sloth learning to go to the washroom all by himself. So it's a really big adventure for Sloth, and it all works out really well in the end. This is fun. So if you know David Shannon's books, he does those No David and Oh David books. And David Goes to School. So this is another book from David Shannon called Roy Digs Dirt. Roy loves dirt. He really loves the dirt. So you get to see all about what Roy gets up to in here. And I'm gonna probably mess this title up a little bit, but this is called Boonoonoonous Hair. Boonoonoonous Hair. This is all about loving your beautiful hair and all the fun different things you can do with it. And it's got beautiful illustrations and celebrating people's differences. This one's cool. So this is a new YA novel we've got here. It's called The Loop, and I'm just going to read you a little bit on the insert page because it describes it the best. So Luca Kane has spent 736 days wrongfully in prison inside The Loop awaiting his execution. Each day is the same, each is torturous, but things are starting to change. Whispers of war are circulating, strange things are happening to the prisoners, and the warden delivers a message, Luca, you have to get out. So. It's all about the decisions that he needs to make, either to stay or to escape, and what might face him on the other side. So this is going to be a really interesting read. Oh, this is very nice. So Going Down Home with Daddy. This is beautiful illustrations, and it's won an award as well here. And the Cadot Honor book. It's got some beautiful illustrations. It's all about a family going home for a family reunion to celebrate their grandmother's birthday. So really nice book, sweet story in there. It's called Going Home with Daddy. And before I get on to reading our next book, I'm just gonna let you guys know the secret word. So if you haven't done your activity badge yet, this is one of the activities on it, is to find the secret word from reading these videos. So the secret word for this week is picnic. So we have a teddy bear picnic on that was earlier today. So if you haven't watched that yet, you can watch it with us. The teddy bear picnic. So the secret word is picnic. And I'm just going to read to you one of my favorite books. This is called The Book with No Pictures by BJ Novak. And I know it might seem like, why are you reading a book with no pictures? Is this even gonna be good? But I swear to you, it's really, really fun. So, The Book with No Pictures. This is a book with no pictures. It might seem like no fun to have someone read you a book with no pictures. It probably seems boring and serious, except here's how the book works. Everything the words say, the person reading the book has to say, no matter what. And that's the deal, that's the rule. So that means even if the words say, blork, wait, what? That doesn't mean anything. Blurf, wait a second, what? This isn't the kind of book I wanted to read. And I have to say all the words the book says? Uh-oh. I am a monkey who taught myself to read. Hey, I'm not a monkey. And now I'm reading this book with my monkey mouth and my monkey voice. Oh, that's not true, I'm not a monkey. Yes, I am a monkey. I am also a robot monkey. Wait, what? And my head is made of blueberry pizza? That's not a thing. Wait a second. Is this whole book a trick? Can I stop reading now, please? No. And now it's time for me to sing you my favorite song. A song? Do I really have to sing? Glug, 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 my face is a bug. I eat ants for breakfast and right off the rug. What? This book is ridiculous. Can I stop reading it yet? No. There are more pages. I have to read the rest. My only friend in the whole wide world is a hippo named Boo Boo Butt. Boo Boo Butt? And also, the kids that I'm reading this book to are the best kids ever in the history of the entire world. Oh, really? And this kid is the smartest kid, too, because this kid chose this book even though it has no pictures. Because the kids know that this book makes grown-ups have to say silly things. And make silly sounds like, oh no, here it comes. Glurp, quack, ma, grumpadoo, ay, 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 brog, 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 baggy, 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 Gilbert, going up, beep, boop, 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 bong, dong, face. Oh my goodness. Please don't ever make me read that book again. It's so silly. In fact, it's completely and utterly preposterous. Next time, please, please, please choose a book with pictures. Please, this is just too ridiculous to read. The end. Bonk. I didn't want to say that. So that's the end of this book, and it even comes with a warning on the back. It says, warning, this book is completely, looks serious, but it's actually completely ridiculous. If a kid is trying to make you read this book, the kid is playing a trick on you. I should have read the warning first. You will end up saying silly things and making everybody laugh and laugh. Don't say I didn't warn you. So that is The Book with No Pictures by BJ Novak. And I am very excited to introduce our guest reader for you now. Our guest reader is the one and the only library CEO, Val Stevens. So she's going to read to you a really fun book with her kids. And I can't wait to show that to you in just a moment.
Hi, I'm Val, and these are my kids. This is?
Kaden.
And this is?
Ella.
And they're going to read this story with me today. I hope you'll enjoy it. It's called, How Do Dinosaurs Learn to Read? This book is written by Jane Yolen and illustrated by Mark Teague, printed by Blue Sky Press. For my mother, who taught me to read because I never got to thank her. To Kathy Westray with gratitude. How does a dinosaur learn how to read? Does he skim through the pages with powerful speed? Does he use his new book as a shovel or bat? Play fetch with a dog? Throw books at the cat? Is that how you guys learn to read?
No.
No. Does she sound out the words or just take a quick look? Does she lose her huge temper, then jump on the book? Have you ever jumped on a book?
No.
I think you have, Kian. Are you supposed to jump on a book?
No.
No, not really. Does she flip every page, but not really look through it? Does she skip the hard words? Does a dinosaur chew it?
No.
Does he read in the tub, make the book a big boat, and then throw a tantrum when it doesn't float? That dinosaur does look mad, doesn't it?
Why?
Ah.
Why?
Because he's put his book in the tub. It's called A Book About Ships. Does he read on the potty while making a mess? Does he stay till the end of the book? Well, I guess. I think you've both done that, haven't you? Stayed on the potty until you're done the book? Does she scratch off the words with the tip of her tail?
Nah.
Does he have a big hissy when reading skills fail? Does a dinosaur wail? Look at that big wailing mouth. No, she's kind to each book, to the cover and pages. She reads very carefully, never has rages. She reads out each word till she knows they sound right. When she snuggles in bed, Mama turns down the light. Then he calls to his parents who stand by the door. Please, Mama, please, Papa, can I read one more?
For 2 days?
Tomorrow, tomorrow, little dinosaur. This is called the Big Book of Fairy Tales. And that's the end of that story.
Yeah.
Thanks for listening.